Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. In today's video, we will look at the development of the mandible. Mandible is considered the strongest bone of the facial skeleton. Its main anatomic parts are listed as the body, the angle which unites the ramus of the mandible to its body, the alveolar process which accommodates the teeth, a condylar process which makes the TMJ along with the temporal bone, and a coronoid process. As it's a lateral view, these processes are present on the contralateral sides too. Let's see where the development of the mandible essentially begins from. The mandible develops from the first pharyngeal arch with the help of the cartilage of the first arch called the Meckel's cartilage. The Meckel's cartilage plays no part in the development of the mandible. Instead, it provides a framework and delimits the region where bone formation would take place. The cartilage extends as a solid, unbroken rod of hyaline cartilage, with its proximal ends connected with the ear capsules, and its distal extremity is joined with its anatomic counterpart through a mesodermal tissue. Let's have a bilateral and superior view of the Meckel's cartilage and look at how the development of the mandible essentially takes place. The Meckel's cartilage will have a lateral aspect and a medial aspect. For simplicity of understanding, let's divide the Meckel's cartilage into three parts: the proximal or the posterior one-third, the middle one-third, and the distal or the anterior one-third. Although we said that the Meckel's cartilage plays no part in the formation of mandible, but it do has the following fate. Its most posterior part of the proximal one-third will form the incus and malleus of the middle ear and the sphenomalleolar ligament. The rest of the cartilage is lost completely. The mandibular branch of the trigeminal nerve has a very close relationship to the Meckel's cartilage. At the middle one-third of the cartilage, the nerve divides into inferior alveolar nerve and lingual nerves, which runs along the lateral and medial aspects of the cartilage. At the distal third of the cartilage, the inferior alveolar nerve further divides into the mental and incisive nerves. At the lateral aspect of the cartilage, a mesenchymal condensation occurs at the site of angle formed between the mental and incisive nerves. This mesenchymal condensation is considered the initial site of osteogenesis. And from this initial site of osteogenesis, intramembranous bone formation will first proceed anteriorly and then posteriorly to the point where the mandibular nerve divides into inferior alveolar and lingual nerves. In this way, the body of the mandible is formed. And this bone formation of the body of the mandible is marked by a bony tubercle called the lingula. The ramus of the mandible is formed by a rapid spread of ossification turning away from the Meckel's cartilage at the level of the lingula. Hence, the ramus is formed. The further growth of mandible until birth occurs by the appearance of three secondary growth cartilages. These secondary growth cartilages are the condylar cartilages, which are considered the most important in the growth of mandible, the coronoid cartilages, and the symphyseal cartilage. I hope this video helps. Please like, subscribe, share, and comment your questions or suggestions. Thank you for watching.